Any image is made by different dots or lines. When we see the image, there is one word we use, clarity. How clear is the image? Now, this clarity in the language of physics is same what we call resolution. There is a picture. In this picture, you find this is written. You are not able to see this, so you magnify this. When you magnify this, it becomes like this. You magnify it further and it becomes like this. This is what you are doing is magnification. But the picture is not getting clear. Suppose we use another type of optical instrument and that gives you this picture, same size, but this is now you say this is clear, but the size is same, it is not magnified. So we say the resolution of this picture is better. Resolution. So here resolution is better, here it is magnified, and if I make it this way, then this is resolved, better resolution and more magnification. So the magnification and the resolution, these two are different things in optics, and this is the example for that. Now, when can we resolve the things is when we see the two objects and we count them as two. Here you don't know whether it is one object or two object. See another example. I show you there are two lines here. This is an image. How many lines are there? You will not be able to make it out. Simply you will say there is one line. Now, I tell you, if I am seeing it, what I see that there is one line, there is another line, and there is a line like this, and this is the letter H. I can also tell you that this may be for another such picture A. For another such picture, this is B. So, all these pictures, if I take it far off, then all of them will appear like this. And for you, it will be one line. For me, this will be two lines separate. Because I am resolving it. So, when you are able to see the two lines as two lines, and if you are not able to see them two lines, you see them one line, one, here two, and how many objects they are really? Two. So if you are able to see two lines separate, two points separate, then you are resolving it, and your eyes are having sufficient resolving power for that particular distance. Now, how do we see the things separate? These are the two points and there is a separation between them. Here are the eyes and they make certain angle with the eyes. and I is able to see that one ray is coming from this direction, one from this direction, and these two are different directions with an angle theta. So I can make out that these two are different points and it will be counted too. Now suppose these two points are taken here with the same distance d, and this is one line, but the other line is this way, very small angle. Then it will be very difficult for I to see whether these are two lines. Like if I write a letter this and show you from here, you are able to make it is H. Here I read it is H. Now I take it there, take it there, and take it to the wall. Can you read a newspaper when it is stick to the wall? Answer is no. You see that there are black spots on the white paper, but you cannot read the letter. Why you cannot read the letter at such a distance? Because these two points make a very small angle on our eyes. And we have seen if this angle is less than 1 minute, then our eyes cannot see them as two points. There will be a blur and that will be a single point. So I will say that I am seeing a black spot, but I am not being able to resolve it, whether it is H, whether it is A, whether it is B, or whether it is a simple thick line. I can't make out. Like this, I can't make out what is this. So what I am not being able to do, I am not able to resolve it. And here I am resolving it, if this is the picture, separate. So seeing the letters and dots separate is known as resolution. And if we want to see anything clearly, the first condition is that our optical instrument, whether it is our eyes, whether it is microscope or telescope, it should be able to resolve the image to show all the points differently. Definition wise, if the two lines are seen separate as two lines, then we are able to resolve it. This is resolution. Now, this distance here, we are seeing the two, or you can say here, we are seeing them the two, so we make them closer. And now again we are seeing them the two, again we make it closer. If we make it closer, now we are not able to see them two. So we are able to see them two separate points up to a certain distance d. And if this d become less, then we will not be able to see those two points separate. Okay, another example, see, these are the two points, I will make it clear. This is the distance d and they make certain angle on the optical instrument, say our eyes, and we are able to see them separate. But if I decrease this distance a little, the angle becomes so small that I cannot separate them. Then this will be known as minimum distance of resolution. D. So what is minimum distance of resolution? It is that minimum distance which I can resolve as two objects. So that is minimum distance of resolution. Now this angle is angle of resolution, minimum angle of resolution up to which I can see them as two points separate. Two points seen as separate is resolution. Two points seen as separate is resolution. Okay. and minimum distance of resolution is this. Now, there is one person who can see this two points if the distance between them is say 1 millimeter. There is another person who can see these two points even if the distance is less than one. This is less than one and still he is able to make out that these are two points and not one blood point, up to 0.5. Now if this case, in case of this person, if he make this distance 0.8, then he will not be able to see them as two. He will say it is only one, not two objects. When he will count at two objects, when the minimum distance between the two is 1 millimeter, what does that mean? That means here is a black spot, here is a black spot, and here is white 1 millimeter, and he is able to make that there are two. Here black spot, and in between it is only 0.5. Still he is able to make out that these are two. Now for this person, if I give him this object at 0.5 millimeter, he will not be able to make out these are two things. If you have gone for eye testing with an optician, you might have seen this, that you are reading certain lines, after that they become blurred. Why they become blurred? Because you are not able to resolve them. So now how do we see the things separate? See that signs. You have understood what is minimum distance of resolution? Now this person seeing it 0.5, this person is seeing it 1 mm, then what is the difference between these two eyes? We will say this eye has got more resolving power. Why? Because it can resolve up to a small distance of 0.5. And this cannot resolve less than 1 millimeter. We have to keep the points at 1 millimeter, then only it can resolve it. So it will be able to read this as H if it is this way, 1 millimeter. But this person will able to read it even if it is written like this. So his resolving power is more, his resolving power is less. That means resolving power is inversely proportionate to the distance. So resolving power is equal to 1 upon d. What is d? D is the distance, minimum distance of resolution. So this is resolving power and minimum distance of resolution. This is for any optical instrument. Now more is the resolving power, more is the separate, we can see the objects separate. Why we need this distance between them? Behind this there is an optical phenomena, that why there is a blurring of two points. If we can see them separate here, why can't we see them separate here? The same person, if he can see them here, why he cannot see them here? What is the reason the things get blurred and thing appear to be one point when actually they are two points? Now this thing we can understand with phenomena of diffraction, what we studied in the previous lecture. See, this is an opening. This is retina of our eyes. Here are two sources of the light. One source, this one, will make an image at this point. And this will make an image at this point. Okay. Now, this is a source of light. This is a source of light. And we know when it is passing through a single opening, it will make a diffraction pattern, and in that diffraction pattern the most prominent part is central maxima, which is wider than the opening. Okay, so here we get this central maxima, which is say this is maximum brightness, so we get a central maxima this white. This is central maxima. Now this will make a central maxima at this point. Here it will be maximum. Here is the first dark above, here is the first dark below, and this will be the brighter. The brightness increase and decrease. Now here is the dark point, here is the dark point. Now on the retina, what do we see? Bright, dark, bright, and we count that there are two openings. Two. Now suppose we decrease this distance and we get another image, and that is like this. This is opening. These are the two sources, S1, S2, and here we get the brightness, central bright, which is this one, and here we get central bright of the other, which is like this one. Now this bright spot and this bright spot are on our retina. Now retina sees here bright, brightness start, bright, 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 bright. Why? Because this is brightness due to source number 2, and by the time this brightness ends, the brightness due to source number 1 start from here. Bright, 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 bright. So what he observed, that this total thing is bright. And now if we ask him how many spots are there, he will say, I see one bright, here is the dark, here is the dark, and between the two dark there is one bright spot. In this case what he told us, here is the dark, here is the dark, here is the dark, and I clearly see two bright spots. Here he say, I am seeing one bright spot. How many are there? Two. Two. What is the difference? The difference is here the angle made is larger, the distance is larger, here the distance is smaller. So even that distance is small, there is a gap between them, but that gap is not here. Why? That gap is not here because of the diffraction pattern, and diffraction pattern is very wide. Central maxima is so wide that they overlap each other. Central maxima overlap. Central maxima overlap. Because of this, we cannot count two. This is the very fundamental why we cannot resolve. Because central maxima overlap. And this central maxima, this angle, this should be large, then we can make it, and we know this angle theta is equal to lambda upon a. So we are not able to make it if the angles are such that they overlap each other. And what is this width? I should not make it this way. Actually, this is from this to this point. This is theta. Anyway, theta is related to it. Okay. Now, this width, this should be small, and there should be separation between the two. Then we will be able to make them separate. So that is the reason. So what is the reason? That we are not able to resolve two points, Answer, the reason is diffraction. How diffraction works on it? Because of the two sources, their central maxima become so wide that it overlaps each other. When it overlaps each other, then the instrument or our eye is not able to make two things separate and it is perceived as one object. So we do not understand whether it is one or two, and we count it as one. Now, how can we measure this resolving power? The minimum distance of resolution, inverse of this, that is 1 upon d, is our resolving power that we have written somewhere. Resolving power is equal to 1 upon d. Okay. Now, all the optical instruments have got certain resolving power and we have counted it. The resolving power, I will make a diagram once again. Okay, we will make a formula for resolution. See, this is the screen. There are two sources here and there is an opening here. From one source, this is the central maxima. For the other source, this is the central maxima. Concentrate here. So, here is the dark point for this. Here is the dark point for this. For this optical instrument, this is the bright point. This is clear cut dark point. This is the bright point and this is the clear cut dark point. And that source is able to count that these are two objects very clearly. So, resolved that they are two objects. If their central maxima are so much distant away that there is a dark point between them. Unless there is a dark point between them, you cannot separate them. This case. This is central maxima for one source. This is central maxima for the other source. Here is the opening. One way here and other ray goes here. So, these are the two central maxima. In this case, it is total brightness. Brightness because of this first source, brightness due to second source, so it is not resolved. See this particular case. In this case, what will happen? The brightness has increased and here maximum brightness because of this. Here, maximum brightness because of this source number 2, it goes on decreasing and again increase. If we separate them slightly, there will be a clear case like this. And if we close them slightly, that will be not resolved case. So, this is just resolved border case. This is known as Rayleigh's case. Now, in this Rayleigh's case, This distance, how much is this distance? This has a width equal to, you know, it is lambda upon A, this. This total will be 2 lambda upon A. This is 2 lambda upon A. And how much will be this? This has been examined that it is equal to this much. This is equal to this much. So, how much it is? Answer, lambda upon A. But when we have the opening of the circular size, there is a little adjustment in this distance and we have found that this distance is equal to 1.22 lambda upon A. This is angle theta. So, if angle theta is like this, then what happens? We just resolved Rayleigh's case, border case. So theta should be, this theta should be a little more than this. So if this is the eye and these are the two points, this angle made is slightly more than theta, then it will be able to resolve it. So resolution has the formula here, the same formula for diffraction, that is the width is one, width is lambda upon a. For circular images, there is a little adjustment and this 1 lambda becomes 1.22 lambda upon a. So angular separation 1.22 lambda upon a, this becomes our formula for resolution. So this is the minimum angle required. Now with this application, this minimum angle required, what should be our formula for resolution or resolving power of microscope and resolving power of telescope? That we will see in the next lecture. And in this lecture we have learnt what is resolution, why there is a need of resolution, what is Rayleigh's border case, why we cannot see two things separate, and what is the minimum angle required for resolution. So in the next lecture we will see microscope and telescope resolving power. Thank you.